Recently, the government of Uganda initiated transitions to program-based budgeting to better align budgets to public policy priorities and to enhance accountability and transparency.
But some of you want the economy. When you hear recovery, you say, they told us the economy is recovering. Where is the recovery? You want to see it, you want to touch it. Huh? Please. Follow the trends you will see.
However, as some government agencies are still grappling with the transformation which was aimed at strengthening the link between government strategic objectives, budget allocations and service delivery outputs, the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Finance, Ramadan Gobi, who also doubles as the Secretary to the Treasury, says it has been a success.
Helping us to reduce on silo mentality, on escapist planning and enclave budgeting. And with those, we shall be able to deliver this country a better economy in the future.
Human rights-based approach, as I mentioned, focuses on the needy, most needy groups. But program-based is on about upper class. That's why in the PDM, a precondition is that you must have 4 acres of land. And you know that access to 4 acres of land is not as easy as saying it.
However, the opposition in parliament is yet to be convinced about the program-based budgeting, and so they have come up with the human rights-based budgeting approach as the better alternative that can deliver service to the people.
We are saying that the government priorities are not actually what they are funding, and that raises the question whether there is sync between NDB3 and the government proposal through the program-based budgeting. Take an example of the propositions for the next financial year, where URA is anticipating to collect 3 trillion extra domestic revenue. We are saying that's a good thing.
In this approach, the opposition wants government budgeting to be informed by the needs and rights of Ugandans. MPs are concerned that many times citizens are detached from the national budget and they are losing appetite for listening to budget speeches because it doesn't address their welfare.
Look at agriculture, for example. Uganda is trading in Europe. Complain that whenever they take their products, many times they're not allowed on their markets. And when we interacted with them, they are insisting it's because Uganda failed to prioritize on putting their certification procedures. So we need to see money being allocated for such priorities, so that there is certification for our export products, especially to Europe, so that we can benefit from those markets. We need such a budget.
They would put more funds in education if they thought about the right to health. Then they would put more money in health. If they thought about the right to food and life, then they would put more money in agriculture.
Led by the leader of opposition in parliament, Mathias Mpuuga, the opposition believes government can be persuaded to use their approach if service delivery is truly their priority.
We're going to have it communicated on a public arena and space on a day we shall choose. So it's our view. Of course, the regime has copied so many things from us without acknowledging them. We shall not be shocked if over time they change and copy our approach to budgeting.
I think for a start it's okay. It's okay for the opposition to sit and have an alternative budget. The question whether or not government will be able to pick something out of it is a big question.
Jonathan Odu, the Shadow Minister of Defense, hailed the human rights-based budgeting approach as the best reform Uganda can have after achieving a lot for many countries across the globe. He says the system facilitates bottoms-up approach in planning and budgeting.
There is hunger in Karamoja. They would donate food without minding what kind of food the Karamojongs actually want.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.